Hey guys, welcome back to my small engine repair channel. As you can see, I'm in full swing with snowblower repairs here. I've got a snowblower that came in the shop. It had a massive oil leak. And in today's video, I'm going to show you why it was leaking oil. And the reason I'm making the video is because sometimes it can be hard to actually pinpoint the exact place where the oil is leaking. So here's the snowblower. It's a Yardworks here in Canada. They're bought at Canadian Tire. They're made by MTD with the Powermore engine. Now, as you can see, the machine is like brand new. These are actually good engines, by the way, guys. I find that they are actually better than Briggs. I never get these engines in the shop blown up like I do with the Briggs ones. Just a brief history on the machine, guys. The customer brought it in. He said it was leaking massive amounts of oil. Even if he just filled it and it was not running, it would still leak. So the first thing I checked was the drain tube for the oil, because sometimes they leak right here where the plug goes on. And I usually put some thread sealant. This is good stuff here. That usually fixes the problem if it's leaking here, as well if it's leaking in the engine crankcase right there. And sometimes they leak where the oil fill tube bolts on the engine or goes into the engine down here. It's actually bolted here and it goes down in the engine there. There's a small O-ring on the tube. I did change that tube and it still leaked. And after it still leaked, after doing those two things I showed you, I realized I better take the covers off, take the flywheel off, and check the seal behind the flywheel. And actually, when I removed the flywheel, the seal just fell out. So the seal had completely popped out of the engine crankcase. So what I've done is ordered a new one. This seal still looks good, by the way, guys. I could put it back in, but because it's for a customer, I don't want to take a chance and have it come out again. Next time I put it in, I will put a bit of RTV silicone or gasket sealant to try to keep it into the engine better. And you can actually see the bearing. The seal goes in front of that. And as I mentioned, it had completely popped out. And you can see the oil everywhere. It was just leaking massive amounts of oil. And if you started the engine up, it would cause it to leak even more because the seal was gone. If you had oil above the bearing here and the machine tipped, it would leak on its own. But as I said, when you started up the engine, the pressure in the crankcase would make the oil come out of the, through the bearing, I mean, and leak all over the floor. So I just wanted to show you guys, if you have this exact same machine, although it may be branded a different brand name and you have a massive oil leak, this might be your problem. This seal is only about 15 bucks here in Canada. It's easy to put in. You just pop it in. You can use a large socket or a piece of pipe that will go around the edges of the seal and push it in evenly. So if you've had a similar experience with these engines, please comment below. Let us know where your snowblower was leaking oil and how you fixed it. One thing I want to mention is during the filming of this video, the customer had not told me that at some point his snowblower engine just backfired, and that since that day, it was just leaking oil like a sieve. So I highly suspect that that's what the cause was, because it may have backfired and some of that pressure may have gone through the engine crankcase and just basically came out with the seal. And I've also put up a video lately on how to replace a crank seal on a snowblower. The link is under the video so that you can go watch it. By the way, the same procedure will almost always be the same on any four-cycle engine. So thanks again for watching, guys. Make sure you're subscribed and that you're following me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and have a great day.